My name is Andrew Brethwaite, and I'm a research engineer and test coordinator at the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. The role of the test coordinator begins when the vehicle first arrives at the VRC. After checking the vehicle in, the test coordinator oversees the entire test preparation process. One of the first test preparation steps is to correctly position the vehicle seats. We follow a standardized protocol and use a device that represents a human occupant to determine exactly where the dummy should sit. Next, we take measurements of the vehicle's structure so that we can measure intrusion after the crash. After that, the vehicle is turned over to the vehicle prep team, who get the rest of the car ready for the test.
Every vehicle that comes into the Institute is assigned a crash test number and a book. This book is our little Bible. It's our checkoff sheets. For everything we do to this vehicle, we need to initial it and date it. This book follows the vehicle all the way through the process, right till post-crash.
I'm just going to do a very quick inspection underneath the vehicle just to make sure that there's no previous damage. I'm draining all the fluids out of the vehicle. That way we don't make a mess right after the crash.
Now that we've drained the fuel from this vehicle, we're going to go ahead and replace that with a solvent that we've dyed purple. It weighs the same as gasoline, but it has a higher flash point.
Just waiting for the gas to come out. There we go. Purple. We're good. Now we have all the gas out. Purple is in the lines, so if there's any leaks, we'll be able to detect them.
We're putting the rack in the vehicle right now. We're getting ready to install all this instrumentation here. It has to be bolted to the heaviest part of the vehicle through the floor so that it doesn't pull loose, doesn't bend. Right now we're installing all the boxes and power supplies to run all the equipment that we're going to be attaching to the vehicle.
The majority of our onboard equipment is mounted in the trunk of the vehicle. This includes power for our onboard camera systems, power for data acquisition, and also our onboard braking unit.
So I've cut the brake lines, and I'm going to be putting some fittings on these lines and a hose which will run from these lines to the back. The red box I'm going to attach these to actually fires nitrogen into the rear brakes, and that's what's going to stop the car if we should need it.
Here are the onboard digital cameras that we're going to be mounting on the door. We need to remove this door panel so we can tie into some stiff structure. Now the front cameras and lights are installed, we're going to move into the rear of the vehicle where we're going to install the rear cameras. So I'm going to measure this and make sure that it's in the exact same spot so the shot looks the same from vehicle to vehicle.
We just bolted the chains on. I welded some hooks onto the subframe on either side. This chain is actually what's going to hook to a skate in the floor, and that's going to pull the car down the runway.
Right now what you're seeing taking place is striping the center of the vehicle. We'll be using these marks in order to align the vehicle on the crash machine before it's tied down. The reason we put targets on the vehicle here is so that we can actually measure the reaction of the dummy and the vehicle itself. We have marks on the side, on the roof. What we can see then is how much the dummy moves from one point to another, how much the steering wheel may move. We can use this for various measurements when we analyze what happens after the crash. We're getting ready now to do the final step in vehicle prep, and that's weighing of the vehicle. We have all our instrumentation in place, and we've added weight to simulate the dummy being in position. This takes just a few minutes, but it's one of the most important things we do. This weight is put into the crash machine and is part of the equation for making sure our speed is right on the money. After the vehicle is fully prepped, it's moved to the crash hall.
The purpose of wheeling the car out into the crash hall before the test is twofold. One, so that we can line the vehicle up at point of impact, and also so that we can frame and focus both our onboard and offboard slow motion cameras. The dummy is also placed in the vehicle in the crash hall before it's pushed down the runway where it will sit overnight in a temperature controlled shed.
418.
418.
In the morning, we proceed with our final preparation before testing, which includes tying the vehicle down to the crash machine, seating the dummy, and applying grease paint so we can determine contact points, and making any last minute adjustments to our onboard instrumentation.
Main battery voltage 12.8.
After everything has been completed and checked, we exit the shed and the test is initiated from the control tower in the crash hall.
Charging is now complete. Test will commence in 4 seconds. 3, 2, 1, we're underway.